Hello, my name is Adrian Perez. I'm from El Paso, Texas, currently living in Tucson, Arizona. And I'm proud to be here with you guys for the 2020 New York City Mariachi Conservatory's workshops, summer workshops. So typically we're there in New York working with a lot of you guys. Unfortunately, due to COVID-19, we're unable to travel. And so through that, we're going to be doing some workshops through video. So I'll be presenting the harp portion. And we'll be stepping through La Hija de Nadie and Se Me Olvidó Otra Vez. I hope you guys enjoy it. Thank you. Hello, I'm going to be going over Se Me Olvidó Otra Vez for harp. Homenaje a Yolanda del Río, transcribed by Álvaro Paulino Jr. I'm looking at the guitarrón music right now, and so I'll just go over some key points of the music here. We're in bass clef. There's two flats, which means we're in the key of B flat. So I'll go ahead and change my levers to that. Okay, so the scale is B flat, C, D, B flat, F, D. Right? A natural, and B flat. Too. So the mapping, we're in 4/4 at a tempo of 82 beats per minute. Typical canción ranchera. We have some pasadas. Yeah, it's pretty standard, nothing out of the ordinary. The nice thing about the bass, understanding the bass and the rhythm parts, is that a lot of these bass notes in standard rancheras kind of give you clues of where the chord is going to change. So anytime there's going to be a B and an F, B flat and an F natural, you can almost assume that it's going to be a B flat chord. Anytime there's an E flat and a B flat, it's almost safe to assume that it's an E flat chord, which is tercera. And then F and C, it's almost safe to assume that it's going to be a segunda chord, which is an F7 chord. All right, so primera, segunda, tercera. So in the mapping, you're gonna start off the song, keep going through the beginning, first set, measures 1 through 4, then you go through measure 5. If you notice, there's a fermata, which means you're basically waiting for the singer to cue you in where time is gonna start again. You keep going to measure 13, you'll notice there's a sign there, which is the S with the little dots. You keep going straight again, all the way to measure 19. Play the whole system through measure 25. At measure 30, at the end of the measure 25 line, you'll notice that there's a 2 coda. And so that'll be important for later down the line for mapping. Then you keep going all the way to 31. At the end of the line of 31, at measure 35, you'll notice it says DS L coda. So that basically means you're gonna go back to the sign, which is measure 13. Right, D sign, 2 sign is what it means. And L coda means once you hit the coda, you're gonna do the jump. So the mapping is at measure 35, you're gonna jump to measure 13 where the sign is, the little S. You play all the way through, next line is 19, you play all the way through and it's measure 25 in its particular line. At measure 30, you're gonna jump where it says 2 coda. You're gonna jump from there to measure 36 where you have the single quarter note. And if you notice, there's another fermata at measure 37, where you kind of just wait, que solo yo te quise, and there'll be a vocal cue of some sort, and that's where the bass scale comes in, pa salir, yeah? Other than that, there's not really much to it. I'll jump over to the rhythm chords real fast to see if there's anything interesting going on. Let's see. B flat 7, E flat, F 7. Yeah, pretty standard harmonia chords. There's nothing really much to it. Yeah, so I'll go ahead and play it with the recording so you guys can hear how it sounds. ¿Avanzada tu segunda? ¿Primera? ¿Segunda? ¿Primera? Measure 25.